Hi students, welcome to Alpha's e-learning chemistry classes for second year. The running chapter is organic chemistry and now we are in session number 4. In previous session we discussed about the mesomeric or resonance effect. In due course we are discussing about the conjugation, conjugative systems and conjugative structures or resonating structures or canonical forms or contributing structures. All these are nothing but different structural formulae what we can write for a given compound from its molecular formula without any displacement in the position of the atoms. We are able to write different structures. In those structures are known as conjugative structures or canonical forms or resonating structures. Clear? And among these different conjugative structures, the actual structure is nothing but a resonance hybrid of all these different conjugative structures. And how to identify the conjugative system we discuss, and then all the contributing structures are not equally contributing for the resonance hybrid, already we know. And now regarding the stability of the conjugative structures, the highest stable conjugative form will contribute more percentage to the real structure. Already we discussed, and then we discussed about the resonance energy. Actually, when we are considering different contributing structures that are participating in the hybridization, that is nothing but in forming the resonance hybrid, if we are considering the energies, we may consider the average energy of all these different contributing structures. Is it not? And generally our view will be like that. But actually the real structure, that is nothing but resonance hybrid energy. Just again you listen, the resonance hybrid is nothing but the actual or real structure energy is less than the lowest energy contributing structure. That is nothing but the highest stable contributing structure or resonating structure will have the lowest energy, but the real structure will have still lower energy than that. Now the difference between these two, that is the energy of the resonance hybrid, which is practically measured, and the energy of the lower or highest stable or lower energy resonating structure, that is considered as resonance energy. Already we discussed till that. Clear? In continuation to that, now let us assume, in case if it is the mesomeric effect, what is that mesomeric effect with all these conjugation? Is it not? Just we discussed the concept or the phenomena that involved in mesomeric effect, but we haven't connected this mesomeric or resonance effect with that one. Now let us connect this concept, what the phenomenon, what we learned till now, that in previous session, that is nothing but conjugation and conjugative systems. Now we have to connect with this mesomeric or resonance effect. Is it not? That is nothing but mesomeric effect or resonance effect. These two are, already I told you in the previous session, slight difference is, in case mesomeric effect, contribution or acceptance of electron is one step or just maximum two step. But in case of conjugation, that is nothing but resonance effect plus or minus effect, the contribution of the electron, when one atom or a chemical species contribute the electron, it will goes on continuously for the next 2-3 steps minimum. In such a case we can consider it, for our competitive examination purpose we can consider like that, it we may consider it as resonance effect. Clear? And let me explain the difference. Say for example, if it is the system, conjugative system, how we can say, all it is discussed already in junior inter as well as in previous session also, this is conjugative system because a pi bond is with the conjugation with a lone pair of electrons. Clear? And now when it is of contributing this electron to this so as to form the pi bond here, this will be off shifted to this, and thereby what we are getting is nothing but CH2 minus CH double bond OR plus. There ends the matter. It is contributing and it is shifted. There ends the matter. In this case, this contribution can be considered as plus M effect. In case, if it is like this, CH2, CH,
N double bond O, O like this. Just in such a case, this pi electron will be shifted to this, and thereby this pi electron will be shifted to this. And now what we are getting is nothing but CH2 plus CH double bond N O minus like this. In this case, as it is withdrawing the electron, pi electrons towards it, we can consider it is minus M. Clear? This can also be considered as plus R, and it is a minus R. In general, both these two terms are considered as the same and same meaning words, but actually for our competitive examination purpose, let us segregate these two separate. In this condition, it is mesomeric but not resonance. Why? In case if it is resonance, let me give this structure. If we are considering benzene ring, in this benzene ring, when OR is present, similar to this, are you following? And when it is contributing the electron for pi bond, when it is shifted to this, it is giving a structure, and when it is shifted to this, it will shift it to this, and thereby OR plus, and now it is getting a minus, and now when it is coming to this, it will come to this, and thereby it is creating one more structure like this, OR plus, and then when it is coming to this, it can also go for this, and where we are getting one more structure like this, and when it is coming to this, it will give the final structure which is similar to that of the first one, that is nothing but OR like this. Unlike that of in these two cases, in this case, say for example, because here also OR group, here just it is donating and it is accepting, there ends the matter, then it is mesomeric effect. But here it is not like that, it is donating continuously, the conjugation is going on to some extent, then we are considering this as plus R, that is resonance effect. Are you following? Just for our competitive examination purpose, this is the difference you have to observe. And in case of NO2 group also, say for example in NO2 group, when present on vinyl, when attached to vinyl group, it is behaving a single step acceptance of the electron pair. But now let me write the same NO2 group on benzene. When it is on benzene, again you can observe a continuous conjugation. It is nothing but when it is shifted to this, it will be shifted to this, and thereby what we are getting is here positive charge, and it is N O minus, and this is, and again when it is positive, it will be shifted to this, thereby it is creating positive charge here, and now N O minus and O, and again when it is shifted to this, we are getting one more positive charge here, and it is N O minus like this, and when it is coming to this, it will come to this, and again we are getting the first structure, that is NO2 is on benzene ring like this. N O O. Here also the withdrawing is happening, it is continuously going on to some extent. In such a case, the group is considered as minus R. In this case, it is minus M, mesomeric, just one step. But here it is in continuation. Then you can consider it as resonance effect. I think, my dear students, now you are able to understand the difference, slight difference between mesomeric and resonance. In most of the books, it may be same. They are considering as the same effect, because plus M or plus R is donating the electron pair, contributing the electron pair for pi bond shifting. And minus R or minus M is nothing but accepting the electron pair for the pi bond shift. So many books, that's why we are in most of the books, what we can observe is plus R or plus M or minus R or minus M. Like that they are referring. So you need not worry, but for our convenience sake, let us assume like this. Are you following? This is about. And now our question is, what are plus R? All the plus R groups are automatically behaving as plus M groups. That's why they are considering both these two same. Actually, their functioning is different. Just what we observe in this case. Is it not? In case if the group is behaving as plus R group, its contribution should be continuous. And whereas, in case if it is plus M group, its contribution is just for one step. That is the difference. But just you remember, all those groups which are behaving as plus M groups, are automatically behaving as plus R groups. Clear? And now, let us assume which are of supposed to have plus M or plus R nature. Plus M or plus R groups. Just you remember, just let me give the key point to identify this plus M or plus R group. These are nothing but except halogens. Just you remember, except halogens. Halogens, you know, they are nothing but fluorine to iodine. Except halogens. Actually, these are also considered, but here for temporary purpose, we are considering exception. Any hetero atom, we can say, hetero atom with a lone pair of electrons. Any hetero atom with lone pair of electron, when connected to the conjugative system, that group is behaving as plus M or plus R group. As let me give examples, OH, it is having two lone pair, and NH2 or NHR or NR2 or OR. Now X, because they are also having lone pairs. Like that, any hetero atom with a lone pair of electron, when connected to the conjugative system, that group is behaving as plus M or plus R group. Are you following? Including the halogens. Why I am giving exception? Actually, halogens are having a special behavior. In terms of resonance or mesomeric, they are plus groups. But in terms of inductive effect, they are minus groups. Where minus I, that is nothing but inductive effect dominates. Okay, we will discuss about that in the coming sessions. We need not worry. Here, all the hetero atoms with a lone pair of electrons, when attached to the conjugative system, such system or such group is behaving as plus R or plus M group. Clear? And now, minus M or minus R groups. Minus M or minus R group. How to identify? Just you remember, any hetero atom, that means other than carbon and hydrogen, with multiple bond, any hetero atom with multiple bond, when connected to the conjugative system, any hetero atom, let me give the examples for this, it is nothing but NO2, where hetero atom oxygen is with multiple bond, or CN nitrogen, hetero atom is with multiple bond, or you can consider CO, where hetero atom oxygen is with multiple bond. That is, multiple bond means here double or triple bond, and then C double bond OH or C double bond OOH, like that we can consider so many groups. Clear? And in such a case, or even we can consider C double bond O NH2. Like that, acids or acid derivatives can also be behaving as minus R minus I group. Just what you have to observe is the hetero atom should be with multiple bond. I think, my dear students, you are following this rule. Just to identify, how to identify minus R minus M group? Just when the bonded atom is having any hetero atom with a multiple bond, then automatically it is considered as minus R or minus M group. Clear? Are you following this? Now, there are some groups which are having both these plus M or plus R and minus M and minus R. Plus M or plus R. Both these two. Don't get confused. Okay, let me give only with one word. There are certain groups which are behaving as plus R on one side and minus r on the other side. Are you following? They are behaving. So here, in such cases, you should be careful because they are making us to confuse. Just you remember, when the group, let me give that group, such cunning groups, here it is nothing but all acid derivatives like this, CO, O minus, carboxylate, and then C, double bond O, NH minus, this type of groups. Here you can observe the lone pair of electrons on this oxygen, and this carbon is behaving, this carbon is having multiple bond with a hetero atom. Are you following? And in such a case, just you remember, in this case, in this type of groups, you observe one half is with multiple bond. That's why when this carbon is with system, if this is the system, here the system is present, then it is minus R. Because the system bonded atom is having multiple bonds. On the other side, lone pair atoms when connected to the system, if here the system is present, then it is plus R. That is what we are considering. Lone pair electrons when present, it is plus R group. That's why in this group, just you observe with a common sense. In this group, this side lone pair is present. But on this side, is the carbon having any lone pair? No. That's why, but it is having a multiple bond with oxygen. That's why it is minus R and this is plus R. So you have to observe which group is connected to the conjugative system. Which group is connected to the conjugative system? If you observe, depending on that, if this group is connected, this part is connected, it is plus R group. If this part is connected, then it is minus R group. Are you following? Are you getting this? Clear? And now, that is about conjugation. That is nothing but a mesomeric or resonance effect. Clear? And now, let us move to the next electron displacement effect. That is nothing but hyperconjugation. In hyperconjugation, conjugation itself is nothing but conjugative system, already we know it is nothing but shifting of the pi electrons or the shifting of the electrons, and where conjugation is nothing but where we can write two or more different structural formulae without any displacement in the position of the atoms, is it not? But here, hyperconjugation. What is that hyperconjugation? Let me give one example. If this is the system, H, 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 here also, and it is with CH2, the best known example, like this, ethyl carbocation. Clear? And now, in this case, we can write different conjugative structures for this without any displacement of the atoms. Now let me write that here. If these sigma bonded electrons are coming to this to form the pi bond, the first conjugative structure appears as H plus double bond CH2, and it is H. And now, instead of this, if it is contributing, then we can observe the second conjugative structure like this, H, H, this is plus double bonded CH2. Instead of this and this, if it is contributing, then we can observe H, C, H, H plus CH2. And now you observe, for this structure, actual structure, it is not actual structure. This structure, we can write different structural formulae. Clear? Different structure. Here, in all these cases, you can observe the position of atoms are not changed. That's why it is conjugation. But if you recollect just what we discussed in conjugation, there is shifting of pi electrons, lone pair of electrons, positive charge, negative charge. But unlike that of there, here, the sigma bonded electrons, just sigma bonded electrons, are shifted, and because of the sigma bonded electrons shifted to form the pi bond, the conjugative structure happen. Such that it seemed to be conjugation, but actually here the excitation is not only to donate the pi bond, actually pi bonded electrons are loosely bound electrons. So automatically any chemical species when tend to donate or accept that pi bonded electrons will easily shifted because they are loosely bound electrons. But when the species of getting excitation, that is nothing but when it is ready to donate, even sacrifice the sigma bonded electrons like this. Here hydrogen is sacrificing its sigma bonded electrons to create the conjugation. Conjugation is nothing but writing different structures, is it not? So here to form the different conjugative structures, it is of donating even the sigma bonded electrons. That excitation, that excitement is known as hyper. Here hyper is towards what? Conjugation. That's why it is known as hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation. For the conjugation purpose, this atom, this hydrogen or the sigma bonded electrons are ready to contribute, to delocalize or displace. And now you observe, because of this hyperconjugation, what is happening is conjugation is happening. That is nothing but resonance is happening. But what type of resonance? If you observe, it is nothing but no bond resonance. No bond resonance. And that's why this hyperconjugation is also known as no bond resonance. Because during hyperconjugation, when the sigma bonded electrons are dislocated so as to form the pi bond or any other purpose, there is no bonding between the hydrogen and the carbon like this. If you observe, this is observed by Baker and Northern, and thereby this effect, that is hyperconjugation effect, is also known as the Baker-Northern effect. Clear? These are different electron displacement effects. And you remember, for this purpose, when it is of conjugation, hyperconjugation, you remember the alpha carbon should possess at least one alpha hydrogen. Then only the hyperconjugations are possible. And one more important, very important, because in previous means, one question is asked like this. Just one question, they asked the question like this. You observe the structure of this. It is given. And now they are asking, here two types of questions. Can you guess how many hyperconjugative structures possible for this? How many hyperconjugative structures for this? Generally, for that purpose, first let me explain these three. Of 1, 2, 3, 4. All these four are not real structures. The actual structure, that is nothing but the real structure, is a hybrid of all these four. Just you remember. Are you following? And now, in case if all these are resonating structures, of these, which are hyper, how many, how of these, whether all the are hyperconjugative structures or only few? If only few, what are they? Just you remember, only these three are hyperconjugative structures. This is not hyperconjugative structure. It is conjugative structure, no doubt at all. Because it is not real, it is also contributing for the real. It is one of the form where we can write the structural formulae. All these happen and thereby it is conjugative. But there is no bond type situation is not there. No bond phenomena is not taking place in this conjugative structure. That's why it is just conjugative structure or contributing structure or resonating structure. Whereas these are no bond resonating structures, that is nothing but hyperconjugative structures. Are you following? And now just if you observe, this is alpha carbon. Three alpha hydrogens are there. Thereby we are having three hyperconjugative structures. Three hyperconjugative structures. In this case, they ask number of hyperconjugative structures. Just you observe, if this is the pi bond, here two hydrogens. These two hydrogens are supposed to be alpha hydrogen because it is functional group, alkene, and this is. And here also, alpha hydrogens two. And this is also alpha hydrogen because it is adjacent to double bond. Clear? So, 3 plus 2 plus 2. Total 7 hyperconjugative structures are possible. And just you remember, instead of hyperconjugative structures, if they ask how many conjugative structures are possible, then it itself is a conjugative structure. Similar to that of this. So number of conjugative structures is nothing but number of conjugative structures is nothing but number of hyperconjugations plus 1, or otherwise number of hyperconjugations is equal to number of conjugative structures minus 1. Or how to find number of hyperconjugations? It is just the number of alpha hydrogens. The number of alpha hydrogens is equal to number of hyperconjugative structures, and the number of conjugative structures is equal to number of hyperconjugative structures plus 1. Plus 1. Are you following all this? This is one very, very important question for competitive examination. Just they will provide like this and they will ask. In case if one more methyl group is there. Now can you guess? Try to answer immediately. Yes, now it is 3 plus 3. 6. 2 plus 2, 4, 6 plus 4, 10 hyperconjugative structures. And in case if they are asking for conjugative structures, 11. How we know that 10 hyperconjugative structures? Because 10 alpha hydrogens. And how we know conjugative structures? 10 plus 1, that is number of hyperconjugations plus 1, is the conjugative structure. Clear? Like that, this is. And now, before closing about these electron displacement effects, we have to consider, in any case, if there is any competition. Competition is nothing but when all are in collective manner, if they are working, there is no competition. They are in coordination. But the competition arises when they are in opposite. One factor is in one direction and the other factor is in another direction. Like that, if any competition is happening in all these, that is nothing but conjugation. Conjugation in terms of it is nothing but either mesomeric or resonance effect. And second one is inductive effect. Inductive effect, it is nothing but I. And then it is hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation, that is phi. They are representing with phi actually in few cases. Hyperconjugation in all these cases. And one more is nothing but electromeric. But actually we should not consider any electromeric effect in comparison with this one, because electromeric effect is always in comparison, in competition only with inductive effect. Already we discussed it in previous session. Inductive effect is permanent displacement, but electromeric effect is a temporary displacement. But which is strong, which is more dominant? Can you guess it? It is, even though temporary effect, electromeric effect is in domination. Why? Because the pi bonded electrons are shifted completely, and whereas in case of inductive effect, the sigma bonded electrons are just dislocate. It is, even though it is of displacing or it is attracted towards more electronegative atom, still the electrons, that is sigma bonded electrons, are in the same orbital. They are not dislocating, just displaced towards more electronegative. So that's why, even though it is permanent effect, when compared to electromeric effect, it is of the loser. That means electromeric effect will dominate. But this electromeric effect only in competition with inductive, and there it is the winner. But now these three are in the same sequence. That is nothing but all these three are having the same motto. That is nothing but the same type of influence in different factors. That is nothing but we can say in determining the stability of the resonating structures, or in deciding the stability of the reaction intermediates, or in deciding the acidic strengths of the acids, or in deciding the basic strengths of the bases, like that. In all these aspects, all these are of having the same type of impact. They render the same type of function towards this species. In such a case, if all these three are present, which we have to consider? That too, in case if they are in the same direction, then we can say that they are in coordination, that it is nothing but leading to reinforce. Reinforce means that effect is dominating. All these collectively push that property. But in case, if in any case, if these properties are in opposite direction, they are not in the same coordination, if they are in opposite direction working, then which is dominating? Which factor we have to consider? Which factor we have to take into consideration to get the nature or behavior of that chemical species? We have to think. For that purpose, just you remember, it is always the R or M. that is resonance or mesomeric effect, which is of involved in conjugation. That is the highest dominating effect. The highest domination, the priority should be given for this. And then it is hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation, because after conjugation, hyperconjugation. Just that's all. Clear? And then we have to go for inductive effect. This is the order where when we are having a tie among these different electron displacement effect to influence the property or the behavior of the compound, we have to consider the proper, that is the electron displacement effects in this order. Just to remember, first conjugative system exhibiting resonance or mesomeric effect is in domination, and then hyperconjugation, and then inductive effect. Clear? This is the order. And now with all these, we are in the next session. This is the conclusion for electron displacement effect, a review, a briefing of electron displacement. Not only briefing, again almost all I explained the total scenario of these electron displacement effects. It is because it is of having much importance in deciding the next coming behaviors or next coming natures. That's why I'm interested to explain this again, for even though you are senior inter students, although you are learned about this in 11th class or in junior inter. And I think I'm not in a hope that you are perfect in this GOC concepts. That's why I'm giving that. Clear? And in next session, let us assume the applications, that is the influence of all these electron displacement effects in different phenomena. It is nothing but stability of the reaction intermediates, and then acidic strengths, and then basic strengths, and then we will enter into reaction mechanism. Clear? Thank you.